Harper Audio presents Femme Fatale by Laura Lippman. Performed by Linda Emond. Copyright 2006 by Laura Lippman. Production copyright 2008 by HarperCollins Publishers.
Femme Fatale. This is true. There comes a time in the life of a beautiful woman, or even an attractive one with an abundance of charm, when she realizes that she can no longer rely on her looks. If she is unusually, exceedingly self-aware, the realization is a timely one. But more typically, it lags the physical reality by several years, like a thunderclap when a lightning storm is passing by. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, boom. 1-1000, 2-1000, 3-1000, 4-1000, 5-1000, boom. The lightning is moving out, away, which is a good thing in nature, but not in the life of a beautiful woman. That's how it happened for Mona. A gorgeous woman at 20, a stunning woman at 30, a striking woman at 40, a handsome woman at 50, she was pretty much done by 60. But only if one knew what she had been once upon a time. And at this point, that knowledge belonged to Mona alone. A 68-year-old widow when she moved into leisure world, she was thought shy and retiring by her neighbors in the Creekside Condos Phase 2. She was actually an incurious snob who had no interest in the people around her. People were overrated, in Mona's opinion, unless they were men, and they might be persuaded to marry you. "This is not my life," she thought, walking the trails that wound through the pseudo-city in suburban Maryland. "This is not what I anticipated." Mona had expected, well, she hadn't thought to expect. To the extent that she had been able to imagine her old age at all, she had thought her sunset years might be something along the lines of Eloise at the Plaza, a posh place in a city center with 24-hour room service and a concierge. Such things were available, but not to those with her resources, explained the earnest young accountant who reviewed the various funds left by Mona's husband, her fourth, although Hal Wickham had believed himself to be her second. "Mr. Wickham has left you with a conservative, diversified portfolio that will cover your costs at a comfortable level. But it's not going to allow you to live in a hotel," the accountant had said a little huffily, almost as if he were one of Hal's children, who had taken the same tone when they realized how much of their father's estate was to go to Mona. But she was his wife, after all, and not some fly-by-night spouse. They had been married 15 years, her personal best. "But there's over $2 million, and the smaller units in that hotel are going for less than $1 million, she said, crossing her legs at the knee and letting her skirt ride up just a bit. Her legs were still quite shapely, but the accountant's eyes slid away from them. A shy one. These bookish types killed her. "If you cash out half of the investments, you earn half as much on the remaining principal, which isn't enough to cover your living."
We hope you enjoyed this preview. To continue listening to this audiobook on Google Play Books, use the link in the video description.